the robots here.
Yep, they are here. And I feel that a lot of us are still waiting for the robots to come into our house, like those old movies. You remember the iRobot movies, the Bicentennial Man movies?
Not to worry, it can be repaired.
Get the nanites.
Yes, doctor.
We're waiting for the robot to come into our house, and they are actually here. On our computers as well as on our phones, our job is to learn how to speak the robot language. We need to learn how to prompt so that we get amazing images as well as amazing audio.
Sawubona, ngingafunda noma yimuphi umbhalo obhalayo lapha.
The robots are here. We must just learn their language.
Just talking to that damn robot.
So let's start. Where do you find these AI tools if you need them? I found this futurepedia.io website. That's the largest AI tools directory, which is updated daily. So you will find AI tools that are free. Some of them are freemium. Some of them have a free trial. Some of them you have to buy. But there's thousands and thousands of them that you could find here and that you could use in your world. One of the new kids on the block that's causing quite a stir in the market is the image creator by Microsoft Bing. I love this tool and I wanted to share it with you and show you how to download it real quick, and you can start using it with the credits that they give you daily. This particular robot is the one that's giving us all these amazing images if we put in the correct prompts in our prompts, and it gives us very detailed, gorgeous images. So we're going to quickly have a look at how you can download this and how you can use it as a text to image on your bag of tricks. This is a Microsoft tool, so you need Microsoft Edge. When you search for Microsoft Edge and you don't have it, it's gonna ask you to download it on your computer or on your phone. So I did that, I added it, and then I searched for Image Creator Microsoft Bing, and then I was in. As easy as that. You need to have an account with Microsoft, of course, but you can create one if you don't have one. And then you are in and you get 15 credits, I think, every day. So then you can start generating images, but you need to have clear prompts. With all of these tools, you need clear prompts and detailed prompts of what you want to have the robot give to you. How do you then talk to this robot or this AI tool? The rule is you have to be detailed as much as possible. Give the robot information that it can generate the image that you want. The 9-year-old, that they're wearing dunks, that they're wearing basketball, that they have the ball on their head, as much detailed as possible. That the clothes are pink, that the clothes have a name on it that's called Ayesha, that they're sitting on a bench, that they give enough information for the tool to generate the information for you. Now we're using Canva as an example. The beautiful thing about the Canva's AI is that if one of the images that were generated you very much like and you want similar images of the same, then you could just click on the three dots or the ellipses and then you tell the tool that I would like more like this. Generate for me more images like this. What I've also used, especially with the Canva AI tool, I told the AI to give me similar images on the four that they're going to generate for me. So that helped me a lot when I was generating for this animation I'm busy creating, to say that now she's at the park, but give me very similar images of the same kind that you've created already. The ellipses and the you instructing the tool to give you similar works for me. Any justice to text to images? If I don't mention the sophisticated tools on the market like Leonardo AI as well as Playground.ai. What is really cool about these sophisticated tools is that they allow you much more leeway to play around with your creativity as well as the images that you are generating. Because there is a place for you to experiment with different styles that you can choose. There's also the prompts that we've now learned. You need to be very detailed with the prompts and include things like Pixar art, illustrations, and anime. So you need to be very detailed when you're writing your prompt. And I've also learned from one of the other creators that I've been watching his videos, is that when you're wanting a girl and you want somebody who looks like, for example, Superman, you could add that if you're creating the Superman, but even though it's a girl. But when you scroll down to the bottom of the page and you exclude, then you exclude men. And for some reason, especially Playground AI, they counteract that and they create a girl for you when you keep on generating images. So it's quite a skill that we need to learn to talk to these robots. The other very nice thing that you could include is you could expand your prompts. But what I really, really like is the exclude from image. We all know that the hands are such a challenge when it comes to us creating images on our text to image tools. So the one way to do that is to exclude funny limbs or extra arms or extra fingers. So that's what you would include on here. When it asks you, what must I exclude from the image? You need to tell the robot that I don't want extra fingers. I don't want texts on my images. I don't want whatever it is that you don't want. We're all crying with the fingers and extra funny looking. That's where you would include. Don't include funny things on my images. Or I want it not to be black and white. I want all color. I want similar. And then you could give the instruction to the tool. One of the other cool things that you could use is adding an image to help the tool to help you get consistency with the images that you're creating. So you could upload an image and use the image as an inspiration, or tell the robot to use the image as an inspiration when they're creating the images for you. Look at this voice AI tool that's on Canva. It's called AIVoov. It speaks my language. How exciting is this? So if you select the language and you scroll down to Zulu in South Africa, you get to listen to Tando and you can preview.
Sawubona, ngingafunda noma imuphi umbhalo obhalayo lapha.
If you want the robots to help you design a logo, go watch this video. I will see you on the next video.